Hi everyone, this is Mario and I'm in the beautiful city of Jakarta. I just wanted to give you some updates about what's happening here in Indonesia. Alright, so you guys can get some real ideas about how to use this information, alright, as part of your forex trades. So let me just get a little bit into this this country. As you would know, Jakarta is considered the financial capital, alright, of Indonesia. The entire population of Indonesia is thereabouts 242 million, alright, in the city of Jakarta. Unofficial estimates puts it at about 10 to 12 million people. Alright, so that is the huge city of Jakarta by itself. I've been here for the last 4 days and I'm just blown away by the immense amount of opportunities that's available here in this city. Alright, so that's one in terms of the population size. Now, talk a little bit about the investment or the economy, alright, of this country as a whole. Alright, did you know that in the start of this year, two of the world's top three ratings agencies called Moody's and Fitch, alright, they recently upgraded the government ratings, all right, of Indonesia to put it in line with investment grade bonds. So S&P would be the one, the next one to follow. And in fact, just last week, okay, Angela Merkel, who is the German Chancellor, and Christine Lagarde, who is the IMF chief, both of these ladies were actually in here in Jakarta just last week. And why were they here? Essentially to just study the economy. One of the great things that Jakarta has done, or rather Indonesia as a whole, what they have done is to actually reduce their government debt burden from 80% of GDP to 24% in the last few years. So these two powerful ladies in the world, they are here to really study the economic powers of Indonesia. So that aside, the investment, the credit history rating, let's talk a little bit about Indonesia's GDP, okay? For the last 1 to 2 quarters, Indonesia has recorded a GDP of about 6.5%. Now that's great, right? Inflation is about 5%, but just last month, in the month of June, it came in at 4.53%. That's not too bad, all right, considering the expansion rate of how they are moving as a country as a whole. Now, Indonesia is also considered a net exporter. All right, figures that came in for the entire year of 2011, the net exports were about 208 billion US dollars. Okay, net imports about 108, so that leaves them as a net exporter for this country. Yeah, their biggest exports, all right, as you would know, crude palm oil. They're the world's largest exporter of crude palm oil. And most of their exports actually land in countries like Japan, China, and USA. And in that order, that means to say that their largest exports land in Japan, followed by China, followed by the USA. Okay, so we talk about exports, we talk about GDP. Let me just leave you with a final piece of information. Let's talk a little bit about interest rates, since interest rates is something that moves the forex markets. Now, earlier this year, I think it was in the month of February, right, it was the first time that the Central Bank of Indonesia actually cut rates from 6% to 5.75%. Now, Indonesia is considered Southeast Asia's largest economy. And the main reason why the government did that was essentially to spur economic growth. They wanted to make money cheaper, all right, for the people here to borrow, such that it will fuel economic movement in the country. And just recently, last month, they paused rates at 5.75% again. Right? So that gives you an idea of how some of the central banks all over Asia, all right, are expecting. And in short, the summary is, whether it's from US to Europe to Asia, or even some of the powerhouses in Southeast Asia, they're all expecting low growth from now towards the end of 2012. If you guys trade the USD IDR, the Indonesian Rupiah, it currently stands at about 9,500. Okay, so all this information, I hope it does help you in some of your trades. For those of you who are trading some of the Asian currencies, you can't afford to ignore the Indonesian economy. This is Mario Singh signing off. For more updates, please log on to my website, mariosingh.com. All right, I'll see you in the Forex Highway. Bye-bye.